My name is Andre Durain. My earliest memory was the memory of me coming out of my mother's uterus on June 10th, 1880, in Tatou, France. I vividly remember the dull colors of the hospital room. I thought to myself, how ugly! That is when I knew I wanted to be an artist. I wanted to revolutionize the use of color because color is such a magical thing. After high school, I attended the Académie Carrière in Paris in 1898, where I met two fellow artists who I became very close friends with. Their names are Maurice Dave Lamnick and Henri Matisse. One day, we were all outside painting landscapes and we started goofing off and throwing paint everywhere. We began making our brush strokes more loose and incorporating bright colors. When our paintings were complete, Matisse suggested we name our newly discovered style of painting Fauvism. This style is what my artwork embodied for the rest of my life. Using color in such ways was beautiful. My advancement in the arts was interrupted by military service in 1901. My time in the military wasn't all bad, though. I began to appreciate scenery and nature to a high degree, and when I was released from the military in 1904, I began painting more landscapes. After the Army, I dedicated my whole life to art. In 1907, I became very good friends with Pablo Picasso, and my work embodied a more cubist feel. With the outbreak of war in 1914, I was forced to return to the Army. After that, though, I began being recognized for my work. I was featured in many art museums and became quite successful. My life was smooth sailing until the Second World War, in which I had to flee my house in 1940 and returned to find that it had been requisitioned. The Nazis treated me with respect, however, because I was associated with the prestige of French culture through my art. Hitler once asked me to come to Germany to paint his family. I refused, but accepted an offer to come to make an official visit to Germany in 1941. That was a mistake because after the war had ended, I was ostracized by many people for collaborating with the Germans. My fame was short-lived, but my artwork has lived on. Contemporary artist Ed Douglas embodies many of my techniques.